Hey guys, it's Mag Synchro with Convertible Turtle again, and yet again, we're going to run against that wall that is Zone 2. If you recall, last time, just kind of was chilling, played a little bit, got frustrated, because, yeah, I'm not good at this game, but hey, it's still fun as hell, and was just talking with everybody. So this time, same thing, but, drum roll, second monitor finally hooked up, finally decided, hey, after last stream, hook it up, had the time for it. So this time we're going to play, and we'll see what we can get into. So, yeah. And here we go. And hopefully, at some point, stop dropping the beat like that. Thought that was a dragon. Yeah, owned by the dragon. Alright, let's see if we can do that a little better. I'm not sure what the heck I'm doing with those things either. Hey, a compass. We had exploding mushrooms in this room, get some gold that way, but hey. Maybe when I actually concentrate, what I can actually accomplish in this game. And spoke too soon. Oh wow, that must have been the boss character, and no clue how to kill that thing, so yeah. Back to the lobby we go to see what wonderful things I could possibly buy to maybe, just maybe, do me a solid here.
Hello.
Scare enemies away. Sure, fear spell sounds wonderful. Maybe I'll be lucky enough to actually loot it. Hey Foxy! How's it going? Getting much better at killing those skeleton things. Basically, if I can pin him against the wall, can actually wind up doing a lot more damage than it looks like. Much better about the skeletons, and then all of a sudden one of them decides to own me. That's an armadillo. And that thing's about to rush me. There we go. Well, still haven't made the shopkeeper in this level yet. Plus 2 damage. We will definitely go with that. Oh, a torch, some armor. Oh, a pile of gold. That'd be cool. Oh, note to self, slow pickaxe does not bust down gold. And we make it to floor 2 and zone. Oh, that's not good. Something wicked this way comes. And it killed me. I was hoping the bomb would have been down enough to be able to have a chance at it. We'll go to the lobby. Buy some stuff.
How's it going?
It's going pretty good, little bitty Merlin.
Hello.
Let's see here. Time out for over just a second. Nothing going on there. See if this janitor will clean anything up that we don't want. Nope, all those are good items. Well, you know, I don't know if it's really hard or not. I mean, I do pretty good off stream. Compared to on-stream. But one of the things that's kind of a hallmark of roguelikes is that you are expected to die a lot while you're trying to figure out everything. And the more you play it, the better you'll get at it. I guess, you know, to a point... Wow, just got beat down by a lot of skeletons. But yeah, to a point, it's going to be like that for any game, right? I mean, as you learn the game, your skills improve. In this case, a lot of it is patterns. Like the mushroom I just killed, he's like every third beat, he splatters. And there's rock golem here. 1, 2, 3, move. 2, 3, move. So, is it hard? Yeah, somewhat. But it's also, am I fully focused on the game? Which, not really. Lose items, gain health. What items could they take away from me? Nothing. So we just wanted to absolutely use that. Because it fully healed me up. Like the skeleton here. Jump, hit, jump, hit. The Banshees, though, they kind of suck. Because as soon as they hit you, or you hit them, they scream, and you can't hear the beat anymore. Some things, you know, you can get away with. Like this armadillo, I'm about to actually unleash it upon me by hitting that rock. And then he gets flipped over. So here is a dancing rock. Had I moved out of the way, instead of standing there like an idiot, I would have been fine. There's a chest, finally. Like this right here. This bush, I'm moving in front of it, move away, and then hit it, so I can avoid getting hit. So it's all, you know, pattern recognition, that kind of thing. These skeleton dudes, they have a spell that they cast, and it drags you to them. This is a mole. It's basically like any other charging enemy, but you can see the tab coming. Oh, I'm about to die. I can hear the shopkeeper. And dead. And we've confirmed that two gems basically doesn't get us anything, so we'll just go to a quick restart. And that's kind of another good thing about this game that I like about it right now, especially. It's such a really low time spend, right? I mean, each playthrough on this, partially because I'm not really all that good at it, but also partially because it's just the way the game's built. I can do, one to five playthroughs in about half an hour. Glass. Okay, that's a horrible one. I don't know what weapon I have at the moment, but it seems like I'm sliding through stuff. It's probably the ring. Yeah, it's part of my internet service, unfortunately. It's been kind of acting up today. I might actually try to adjust the stream settings in a second. Maybe help with bandwidth usage. Yeah, there we go. So, dead. We'll go back to the lobby and just a second here. I'm gonna go adjust OBS for a second. Thank you. I'm also checking my bandwidth to see how horrible that is right now. Because I think that's the problem, and if that's the case, I absolutely got to report that to my ISP. But, I can actually walk and chew bubblegum at the same time, why not? This may or may not cause some problems with the stream just by doing an internet test. My rhythm for a second. Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on with YouTube. My actual bandwidth and everything is doing really good at the moment, so it's gotta be something with the actual YouTube site, maybe. I thought it was internet. It was really easy to blame Comcast. Come on. It absolutely could be YouTube being hit with a lot of cat videos, Russ. That is definitely a possibility. And welcome to the stream, man. You must be really bored to be watching me play this game with your opinion of it. Appreciate it, though. I just got really badly owned by all that. That's so horrible, just everything over there. Yeah, definitely not gonna even go mess with that. Yeah, I just ran two speed tests and I'm pushing like over 10 meg for each upload, so I don't know. I doubt it's the internet connection on the computer itself at this point. Oh, these things. Alright, I timed my bomb wrong. That's just not good. Sell one of your items? It won't buy that. It won't buy that. I am way not good. Oh, hey, this song ended and saved my life. That is not good. It dumped me right in a horrible place. And that's one of the reasons why you want to make sure that if you ever play this game, you get to the exit, beat the boss, and get out in time. Otherwise, you get put down into that mess. Yeah. That's valid. So that means instead of getting like 3 views today, I probably get like 5? It's kind of cool. Yeah, I'm kind of torn about that. On the one hand, I really wish Saturday morning cartoons would make a comeback. Yeah, my last stream, man, I'm actually showing a real good connection now, according to YouTube. Come on. So yeah, maybe we'll whatever it is will be done. Oh, well, just in time, watch me die again. All right, back to the lobby. Nope, we only got two gems again. All right, let's see here. Occasionally, I can actually have a real good night to run like that. After I have a good run like that, I have a really horrible one like that. Win items if you're lucky. Well, we have everything we really want from the seller, so let's try. We only got a broadsword. There we go. Probably my favorite weapon in the whole entire game is the spear. Get the reach on it. To mention that because of its reach, people like me that can't figure out patterns sometimes get a lot of forgiveness. And again, not the exit, so we dropped through. But this time we're close enough to the exit where we're okay. Oh yeah, with there being other colored... I have no clue what that was. That's interesting. Some sort of swamp monster. Excellent. Oh, he wants the golden key. That's what I thought. Yeah. ASCII? Is that... Oh. So, lots of keys in this level. And we're about to die, so that's always never a good sign. Gotta love the soundtrack though. Real nice, peaceful music. So we're probably at a boss now. Nope? Okay. Hey, that's good. I wasn't really looking forward to... Really looking forward to a boss punch, so... That did more than hurt. Stand still, keep multiplier. Oh, that's cool. Oh yeah, none of the gold. I wish. The gold key was in the shop for 400 coins, which is way outside my available price range. Hey, there's the glass cage though, I think. Yep. That's awesome. And dead. Well, that's the way it works sometimes. We got 6 coins. We definitely want to go to the library this time. We just unlocked a new NPC, so we'll have to see who it is. I know it's not the Beastmaster. It's not the Codex. Hey, Diamond Dealer. Oh. Take these on your next non-all zones run. Oh, wow. Okay, I am so glad I have the glass key for this guy, because... Yes. That's definitely worth the gems. Holy garbage. Okay.
Hi.
Let's see here. Give what you need. I don't know what that means, but we'll buy it. Alright, so now we'll be starting zone 2 with a mining hat and a broadsword. Will definitely make the level well, it should make the Redsword's awesome, should make the level a lot more bearable, but so far what it seemed to manage to do is make me way more unconfident and get me boned almost. Oh, monocle we definitely want. That was a plus too. That's the first time I think I've killed one of those horses in a while. There's a good chest with armor in it. Looks like we gotta go this way. Monocle lets you see where all the items are on the screen. So, like, over here I can see that there's a mushroom, and then sure enough, there's a mushroom. You see the little pile of gold right there, down the bottom, and the spell. Can't get that spell from that chest. Oh, hello. Rent, damaged, and shattered. I don't think I want anything to do with that. And dead. Okay. Back to lobby. Especially now that we have the gym trader.
How's it going?
Alright, so we got a plus damage dagger or plus vision radius. I think we'll take the vision radius. The dagger, while nice, I hope to get a better weapon near some moment. The real big important thing about the monocle is in some of these actual wall boundaries, you can actually find gemstones, like buried inside the rock, and so it's just really good to be able to get to them. And like you can see superimposed on the box there, that there's actually a golden box. And here's a spear. Yes. We will take that spear. So basically it's x-ray vision is what it all boils out to. That's a really good benefit of the monocle also. Right there is a bomb. More bombs. Wow. So, killing the shopkeeper is actually fun to do, because everything becomes free. But the easiest way to do it, that I know of at least, requires two bombs. So that's why I was extremely happy to do those bombs. Unfortunate way to freeze on it, but I didn't die. So there's that. I think our song's about over, so we'll go next level. Okay. That was interesting. And there's a dragon, which that was bit of faster speed dragon than what I usually see. Wow, okay. Alright. Return to lobby. And back to new. Hey, that's right, we did save another guy, Weapon Master. I'll let you switch weapons for training. Wait, what? Thank you. So that's actually a bit that I haven't seen yet. One thing I still have yet to use in this whole entire game is the whip. I bought it at one point. I actually had the custodian take it out of the levels.
Hello.
Because, quite frankly, it attacks in a really weird angle, weird shape, and just getting on the fly is just not good for anybody. It actually attacks like a knight with moving chess.
Hey.
Yes, dragons are bad. And, I mean, they're so bad, actually, that the game allows you to practice against all the bosses under the codex here. And, like, the dragon one is...
Oh!
I finally beat the dragon training, but I still don't know exactly what I'm doing against them half the time. I don't know, there's places I can go and Google it and look it up, but in this particular kind of game, I'd much rather I figure it out on my own. Okay, let's go back to Cadence. Is this the playthrough we're trying? Now, the dragons are just horrible to fight against. Yeah, they do have a ranged attack. Oh, what I have now? Yeah, it's a ranged attack, except for you have to reload. And I'm not sure really what good the ranged attack does entirely. Oh, wow. Okay. That's kind of cool. Keen on the reload thing, but I can look up and get things all the way across the screen. Oh, the dragon flame goes all the way across the screen. If you are in its LOS, it will flame you. But it also flames on the even beats. So, oh, shopping spree. Heck yeah. I guess the game has even started feeling sorry for me, guys. We'll keep that shopping spree in our back pocket for a while. I don't think I'm going to kill. It's... Alright, that's... That's definitely a first. Well, that's good to know. So with the crossbow, I'm actually able to melee people still. And walk horrible place we wound up in this time. Alright, not a suicide drop again. So we're good with that.
Oh.
unfortunate. Then we got 4 gems. Let's see.
Hello.
Damaged non-flying enemies, freeze enemies. Not really feeling that one.
Hey.
Multiplayer based light. That sounds kind of neat. See if anything in the gem crate is worth a gem at this point.
How's it going?
Helps with some terrain. Yeah, well, we'll take that since our gems go away anyways. This actually shows you where you got to go to get the hell out of Dodge. But it's helpful. Being kind of all sneaky, like, I threw my dagger. So I was like, oh, I can get turn release, so I'll just go ahead and throw the dagger. That'd be a cool way to take care of these guys, right? And that just didn't work. That was me fat fingering the wrong buttons. Dead. Again. Starting with a spear. That's good. This will probably be the last one, guys. After this death, which I'm pretty sure is going to happen, we will be calling it a night, or a day, or a morning, or wherever you live. Thank you. much everywhere that we really care about at the moment. All right. I'd say one of my favorite pirates except for in this one. Oh, wow. Oh my god. So, yikes. Blue Dragon's new. Never seen one of them before. Red Dragon, all new too well, because he's playing me so much times. Green Dragon, he's usually easy to beat. So I blew up totally got wrecked. So when you blow up an actual shrine, it will release items in it. You can see where those items released. One thing I was not aware about this particular room is that was not good, apparently. that was horrible. that was so bad it was fun. Yikes. So apparently, if you get the secret shrine room and blow up the shrines, you can get the item, but there'd be a whole lot of dragons. So on that note, guys, I think we're going to go ahead and call it, because I got to get ready for another day of work. Thanks for watching the stream, everybody. Appreciate you being here. Looks like, almost made an hour this morning, so that's cool. Like, share, comment, subscribe. Appreciate you spending your time with me. Just do all those things that you can say that you did to make me famous. And one of these days, maybe we'll all be famous. But take care, guys, and have a good day.